So in this lecture, let us cover the second half of the unit, measurements and instrumentation. So before getting into the classification, we'll just know what instruments are. So measurements will involve the use of instruments as a physical means of determining quantities or any kind of variable. So generally, instruments can be classified into two categories, absolute measurements and secondary instruments. So absolute instruments give the magnitude of the quantity. For example, a tangent galvanometer will measure the quantity of the current, which means the magnitude of current. Secondary instrument, the quantity being measured can be only measured by observing the output indicated by the instrument. So generally these instruments are calibrated by comparison with an absolute instrument or any other secondary instrument. For example, take meter bridge or any Ohm's law application instruments can be considered as secondary instruments. Here we classify instruments into three categories: indicating, recording and integrating. Let us look at them one by one. So first we'll start with indicating instruments. Indicating instruments can be classified based on the measurement quantity. So we have six classification here. So PMMC, moving iron, electrodynamometer, hot wire, thermocouple, electrostatic. Let us look at them one by one. So the first type of instrument which we are going to study is permanent magnet moving coil instrument. Moving coil and moving iron both are very important. So as you look on the screen, this is the typical diagram of permanent magnet moving coil. Here we have permanent magnet having north pole and south pole. In between the permanent magnet we have the core, the central core, which is made up of iron, right? So outer to the core we have a former. This former is either cylindrical in shape or rectangular in shape. So here we are using a rectangular former. Aluminium former is placed in between these two pole gaps. So outer to the former we have the coil wrapped, right? So the coil is made up of copper. So iron core inside the core is used to provide a low reluctance flux path, so it can produce a strong magnetic field from the coil to move. That is why it is used for the measurement of DC. The permanent magnet can be made up of alnico, which is the commonly used metal, alloy, okay, which is the commonly used material, or alcomax. So these type of magnetic materials can be chosen based upon the field intensities, whether you need low field intensity or high field intensity. So this material will serve as the core, alnico or alcomax. So if you see in the diagram, there is a spindle. So this part, this central rod like structure is the spindle. Generally we will be having air springs on either side of the spindle. So these two air springs is made up of phosphor bronze, and what happens is electromagnetic damping occurs due to the change in the direction of induced current in the core. So the total energy, that is the potential energy of the system, is liberated as heat due to eddy currents in the core. So damping torque is produced by the eddy current in the aluminium former in case which is highly sufficient in measurement of the parameter. So PMMC can be widely used for voltage measurement. You may ask me, can it be used for current measurement? Yes, PMMC can also be used for current measurement. The only difference based on the construction is this core material. Previously we saw it was made up of a metallic material. Okay, in case if the core iron material is not non-metallic, it is not metallic, right? Which means The damping torque is provided by a low resistance connected with the coil. So when the polarity is reversed, the torque developed in the opposite direction does not allow any deflection in the opposite direction. So here we have a scale, okay, a scale and a pointer. So this pointer will show the deflection. This is an indicating instrument, so it simply indicates what is the level of voltage level, magnitude of voltage, what is the magnitude of current upon achieving damping torque. Okay, so the most important equation, we have the torque equation. Generally, torque is nothing but force into distance. So force is NbIL and distance will be d. So we know LD will be the area. So area is the effective coil area. It is measured in meter squared. N, we know the number of turns in the coil. B is the flux density in the air gap. And I will be the current passing through the moving coil. It is measured in amps. So we know LD is equal to A. Substituting that, we get TD is equal to NbIA. Another controlling torque, the spindle. Okay, provides the necessary controlling torque, and this restoring torque is produced by this torsional head. This restoring torque is produced by the torsional head, and controlling torque TC will be equal to KS into theta, where KS is the spring constant and theta will be the angular deflection in radians. Moving on to the next type of instrument, moving iron instrument. So moving iron instrument can measure both voltages and currents, like our moving coil instrument. And there are two types of moving iron. One is the attraction type and the other one is the repulsion type. Under repulsion type, we have another classification, radial vane and coaxial vane. Vane is nothing but a plate. So we'll look at the diagram for better understanding. The diagram will depict moving iron type instrument. It is an attraction type. How can you differentiate an attraction and a repulsion type? This is one question which you will ask me. So moving iron instrument will have a stationary coil which is excited by either current or voltage which is under measurement. So it also consists of a plate or a vane. I told you vane is also called as plate, right? This plate is made up of soft iron in case of attraction type, whereas in repulsion type, instead of one vane, there will be two vanes. So here, let me show you with a marker. So here, this is the vane. This is where a vane will be present or a plate will be present. So attraction type, so one vane facilitates the required damping, right? So a coil, these are the coils which are placed over the magnet. Okay, so this coil, what happens? In this coil, because of the movement of the vane, there will be a magnetic field. So this magnetic field produced by the stationary coil. So supply will be given to the stationary coil. It becomes an electromagnetic vane and moves to increase the flux of the electromagnet. So the vane tries to occupy the portion of minimum reluctance. Reluctance is inversely inverse to the inductance. So when reluctance is high, inductance will be less. So the vane will try to occupy in the portion of minimum reluctance, which means inductance is high. So this force is the deflecting torque. So coming to the repulsion type, what is the main difference is we have two vanes here. If you see, there are two plates. So one is a fixed plate. This one is a fixed plate. Vane number two is a fixed plate. And the other vane is the moving plate. It tries to move in the path of minimum reluctance such that inductance will be high. So again, we saw two types where radial vane and coaxial vane. What is the main difference? So in radial vane type, vanes are radial strips of iron Whereas in coaxial type, there will be sections of coaxial cylinders. They are busy.